What's up, Toberos? Welcome back to another video. Welcome back to the channel of Car Enthusiasts. Today in front of us is the all-new Alcazar facelift 2024. This car starts at 14.99 lakhs petrol and 15.99 lakhs with the diesel. Before we get started, don't forget to like the video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and press that bell notification icon so you don't miss any of my future uploads, guys. So let's get started straight away. Let's dive into this all-new Alcazar. Get the Hyundai logo, finishing siren. This portion is finished in glossy black. You get the similar connected taillight treatment that you get in the Creta, but this portion is slightly different. And this looks more sorted than what we get in the Creta. You get the H-shaped DRL headlamps on the side, and this strip runs in the middle. Your grille is finished in glossy black. You get a camera placement in the front, 4 parking sensors with the level 2 ADAS radar placed below, and the camera placed on the windscreen. Regular wipers, no aero twin wipers in this. You do get LED-based white headlamps. And they're of course reflector base, not projector. 4 parking sensors in the front, which I've already mentioned. You get your towing hook in the front. This portion is finished in silver, the skid plate treatment. And that is what it is. You do get some design treatment on the sides. No visible air curtains whatsoever. This is a 1.5 turbo petrol variant. Churns 158 horsepower with 253 newton meters of torque. This is a tried and tested engine. If you want to see the engine's performance, I have driven the Kia Seltos 1.5 turbo. You can go and check that out on the top right corner. I'll place the video over there.
This is what you get under the hood. 158 horsepower with 253 newton meters of torque. That's a turbo petrol engine, turbo smart stream. Insulation is present, of course, no hydraulic struts. You get a stand, and this is how the engine layout is. Let me know your thoughts. Let's close it and explore the rest of the car.
Let's move to the side. Body cutting wise, you get glossy black finish, runs all the way to the rear, but side skirt treatment wise, you get the silver chunky treatment, which makes it more aggressive. 18 inch alloys, 215/55 R18 with discs in the front. Nice alloy design. This is a new alloy design, which looks really nice. DCT badging. This is the topmost variant, the turbo petrol variant. You get DCT only in the turbo petrol variant. The torque converter comes with the diesel. You get a blind spot monitoring camera on the ORBMs. This is the turn indicator setup. Nice deep green, emerald green finish on the body. Nice color, in my opinion. What do you guys think of the color? Do let me know. Request sensor only for the driver's side. You don't get request sensor on the co-driver's side, nor in the rear side. And roof rails are functional. Roof rail design is different from what we see usually. You get a panoramic sunroof, blacked out shark fin antenna as well. Your P-pillar treatment is finished in matte black. A-pillar is finished in glossy black. This particular portion completely till the C-pillar is finished in glossy black. And that's what it is. So kind of gives a dual tone kind of a vibe, but it's not dual tone, of course. Coming to the rear, before we get to the rear, you do get disc brakes for the rear wheel as well, which is neat. And this is what the treatment of the light is at the rear, guys. This is kind of an H-shaped treatment. This is for your indicator, the dynamic swipe indicators. Alcazar is written inside the glass, finished in satin. Hyundai logo, finished in satin. Rear wiper, rear defogger, and your high mounted stop lamp is also present. Signature badging, turbo badging is also present on the boot. 4 parking sensors with a parking camera present at the rear, and you get your reflector treatments as well. Your skid plate at the rear is finished in silver. This is your dual exhaust treatment. Spare wheel treatment is below. Steel rim, of course. And opening the boot, the story of the boot, you do get a 50-50 setup. You can fold these seats down, increase the boot carrying capacity. This is your boot lamp treatment, finished in halogen. Subwoofer treatment on the left side. You get 8 speakers in this car. The sound quality is going to be amazing because it is from Bose. So that is what it is. Below, you get your toolkit treatment for changing your tire. You can see that Bose car amplifier, I believe. And that's what it is. You get your warning triangle present as well. Let's close the boot, and that's how it is. This is the story of the rear. On the left side, you get the fuel lit treatment. Of course, there is no request sensor for the co-driver, as you guys can see. Space is less over there, so we're not going to go over there. Anyway, this is the story of the exterior of the all-new Alcazar 2024 signature variant, the turbo petrol variant, of course. Let me know your thoughts, guys. What do you guys think of the design updates that it has come with? You can see the indicator treatment. Let me know your thoughts, guys. What do you guys think of the exterior? The changes that they have updated it with. What are your thoughts? What they could have done better? Is it a thumbs up for you or thumbs down for you? Do let me know that as well. Now we'll get inside the car and see what it has on offer in terms of features, comfort, and practicality. Let's not delay. Let's get inside the all-new Alcazar straight away, guys.
We are about to enter the rear, but before we get inside, let me show you what do we have on the driver's side functions. You do get your door lock and unlock options, ORVM functions, all windows are automatic. Drivers, one touch up and down, lock and unlock the window function is also present. You do get memory function for the driver's seat as well. Both the driver and the co-driver's seat are electronically adjustable. Memory function is only available for the driver's seat, and you get boss mode function for the co-driver, which is again automatic. So we're going to close the door. The door thud sounds pretty good. In terms of driver functions, you also get your engine start stop button placed on the right side, auto start stop, traction control, front parking sensor, and your headlight adjuster is also available. Steering wise, the car is pretty sorted. Steering wheel is really nice, flat bottom, nice glossy black treatment. You don't get this in the previous Alcazar. This is an update. We're going to be pressing the brake and just doing a soft start of the car. And you can see the blind spot monitoring camera in action, and on the other side as well. So that's pretty neat. This is your ADAS feature in the middle. In terms of steering functions, your ADAS and cruise control is on the right side, and your music functions is on the left side, guys. That's what it is in terms of what you get on the steering wheel. You do get paddle shifters on the steering wheel as well. Shift down, shift up, that's what it is. That's your wiper control and your indicator control and headlight control on the right side. 10.25 inch screen setup. Your instrument cluster is also digital, and your infotainment system is also digital, which we have explored this in detail. You can go check that video out on the top right corner. It gets the same system as you get in the Creta and the Seltos. We explore the Creta's infotainment system. You can definitely check that out and get an idea of what the infotainment system offers, guys. So in terms of instrument cluster, MID, this is what you get. Your compass, tire pressure, and your ADAS settings, lane keep assist basically, and rest, we drive to display is there. You do get drive modes as well present on the console, so you can change drive, traction, normal, and sport and eco. You can see those block changes. They also turn circular, but it's maybe blocks dikha raha hai. So that is what it is. The rest of the function, you do get digital speedometer, you get since refuel data, since last reset, auto stop, and that's what it is, guys. Anything else? Tire pressure apart from that. Okay, that's about it, guys, in terms of what we get in the instrument cluster. This is your infotainment system, which is pretty similar. We have already explored this infotainment system in detail, guys. So if you want to go check that out, I've already placed the video in the link and you can check that out over there. It's the same infotainment system, very smooth, very slick to use, and there's no complaints whatsoever, guys. Huh, this car has no air purifier. Now the air purifier has been removed, and in terms of charging sockets, you get USB-C, USB-A, 12 watt charging socket. This particular system, if you remember in the Creta, we had buttons and everything, but this is capacitive touch kind of a system. You can see setup, navigation, radio, it's all touch based now. You don't get you don't get any buttons whatsoever except for the knobs over here, and for your AC control you have buttons for your temperature and volume. Of course, this has dual zone climate control, so that's pretty neat. Ambient light displays over there as well. In terms of RVM, you do get auto dimming RVM with SOS breakdown function and Bluelink. You do get a digital key in this where you can use your phone and unlock the car. That is via Bluelink, just letting you all know. So that system, that facility feature is also available in this car. You do get a magnet, same as you get in the Creta. And this is finished in a nice tan kind of a color, and it looks pretty good. This is your glove box function, which has cooling function, which is pretty nice. Bose speaker setup, aap dekh sakte ho, Bose ki badging hai on the speaker, which, you know, of course is a premium sound system. This car also is pretty premium. In terms of center console, you get your DCT gearbox, 7-speed, you get a 360 degree camera. This is the camera quality, which is pretty amazing, guys. I mean, it is so clear. Clarity wise, there is no complaints whatsoever. The camera quality is top notch. You do get hill descent control, auto hold function, parking brake function, ventilated seats for the driver, co-driver, and the second row passengers as well. So that is also pretty neat, and you can of course set your levels and everything. 2 cup holder storage. This is the key of the car. Lock, unlock, and boot opening function is available. Hyundai logo is the back. Your armrest is adjustable. Armrest storage is pretty deep. Slidable armrest. And that's pretty much it from the front. You do get sunglass holders. You get LED based cabin lights. This is for your sunroof. You get a panoramic sunroof, guys. You can see the cover is opening. It's pretty smooth. And the sunroof is massive, guys. We will get to the rear and I'll show you how the sunroof is. Vanity mirror for the co-driver, ticket holder for the driver, guys. Steering feel is pretty light, very easy to turn and everything. I don't see any difficulty whatsoever, guys. So in terms of driving, you will find it very comfortable for sure, because the seats also a very comfortable place to be in. The ride height is pretty good. The car is it feels massive, it feels big to sit inside. So if you are someone who's into big cars, SUV cars, you know, you can definitely consider the Alcazar, because from the inside it feels very comfortable and it feels very sorted, guys, in terms of what it has to offer. So far it feels very premium as well, no doubt about that. In terms of features also, it's very rich with features, and to explain those features it'll take another video. So you can definitely get an idea. But anyway, this is what it is in terms of what we have in the front. Let's go to the second row and see what's the offering over there. Guys, about to enter the second row. One thing I'd like to mention, guys, is that this car comes with welcome and goodbye function for the driver's seat. So that's also another neat premium feature that you get with the signature variant, guys. See, the seat is going forward as the door was closed. Two AC vents at the second row, two USB-C charging sockets. You can store your phone, of course, so your storage is pretty deep. And of course, you do get a tray that you can, you know, pull up basically, so that you can keep your laptop and eat your food. So basically you're getting an airline level treatment. And you get ventilated seat function for the second row passenger, and of course window roll and up and down button. Door handle storage is also available. Door storage is also big enough. You can store your 1 liter bottle and your knickknacks. In terms of seat comfort, you do have the thigh support adjustment feature, where you can pull this forward and take it back if you wish to. You get boss mode function, where you can, you know, push the co-driver seat forward, or you know, recline the seat and push it forward as well. That function is also available, which is pretty neat. You do get sunshades at the rear. You get cabin lights with retractable grab handles on both sides. Massive panoramic sunroof. So if you're a sunroof fan, I mean, this car is fulfilling that need for you as well. It's big, it's loaded, it's got that turbo petrol engine. It looks good, it looks aggressive, looks chunky. I mean, it is the complete package, guys, so far. So in terms of knee room, is pretty great. Foot room is even better. Thigh support is top notch, guys. No problems there whatsoever. And you do get slight hum in the middle, but you can just walk to the third row, which will be very easy for you. It won't be a problem whatsoever. Let's go to the third row, guys. I don't think anything else is left to explore in the second row. Let's go to the third row and see what we have over there. Now going to the third row, this is very easy for me to go. And so as you guys can see, for a guy like me, even in the previous Alcazar, dimension wise is almost the same, there's nothing different. For a guy who's 6 feet tall, it'll be slightly uncomfortable. I think it'll be more than uncomfortable. I don't think people who are 6 feet, I think 5'9 and above should sit here. 5'4, 5'5 tak. Yeah, theek hai. It won't be a problem, guys. So that is one thing. And you can see my knee room and foot room, how it is. And yeah, what else do we get at the rear? USB-C, AC blower functions, cup holder, and some storage with the AC vent. At the rear, USB-C, AC vent, cup holder, and another cup holder. So practicality is there, but space ke maamle mein, the third row is not at all for tall people whatsoever. For kids, for people who are 5'4", 5'5", I think it's decent. It'll do the job. So you are getting that extra space. If you are not using this space, you can use it for your luggage carrying capacity. That is also an option that you do have. You can hold the seats and everything. So this is the story of the third row, guys. And yeah, you do get seat belt options. So let's get out now, guys. This is what it is in terms of what we get in the all new Alcazar 2024. Let's get outside and conclude the video finally. So guys, this was my video of the Alcazar facelift 2024. Guys, this is the complete package. It's got level 2 ADAS. The car is aggressive, the car is muscular and chunky from the front. In terms of lighting also, it looks more sorted than the Creta in my opinion. In terms of styling from the front, it looks much more mature. But do let me know your thoughts, which do you prefer, the Creta or the Alcazar? This car is of course bigger than the Creta and it has much more road presence comparatively. It has got the same turbo petrol engine. So tried and tested, reliable, no problems there also. So got a lot of things in the inside as well, ambient lighting, pause mode, you've got memory seat functions, ventilated seats for the driver and the co-driver, ventilated seats for the second row. So lot of tech is loaded. Bose ka speakers bhi aata hai isme. Lot of tech is loaded in this car, as we are all aware how the Creta was. It is mostly similar, but this gets a little bit more compared to what we got in the Creta. But anyway, this is my video of the Alcazar facelift 2024, guys. It is the complete package in my opinion. Looks and feels good overall. Do let me know your thoughts. What do you guys think? Which one would you choose, the Creta or the Alcazar or the Seltos? Which is your favorite? Do let me know that as well. And thank you so much for joining me in this video, guys. Do leave a like, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and press that bell notification icon so you don't miss any of my future uploads, guys. I really appreciate your support. I will see you in the next one. Then take care and stay safe, Turbo Rivers. Bye-bye.